The eventful morning began with the Prime Minister greeting Her Majesty the Queen, titular head of the Commonwealth, who came to preside over the opening ceremonies of this Heads of Government meeting. It started with the sacred welcome by Australia's Aborigines, who offered prayers and salutations that this 2011 CHOGM will produce meaningful results on behalf of the Commonwealth's 2.1 billion people. To put it mildly, it was nothing short of a production that was tasteful and appropriate, considering Australia's long and diverse history. Then came the thoughts of four leaders upon whose shoulders rests the immediate future of a quarter of the world's population, the first of whom, host Prime Minister Julia Gillard, set the tone for the 21st Heads of Government meeting in Perth, saying that the time for action is now.
Unlike other global bodies united by practical concerns such as commerce or trade, we are also joined by a very different motivation. We are a Commonwealth of values, shared values of peace, democracy, racial equality, the rule of law, and a commitment to social and economic progress.
Commonwealth Secretary General Kamla Sharma recalled the successes of the 1981 CHOGM in Melbourne, but noted that this West Australian mining city will stand as a greater watershed in the way the global organization serves its people, because times are different and challenges are even greater.
We decided our 2011 theme should be women as agents of change, with Prime Minister Persad-Bissessar handing over the chair to Prime Minister Gillard. We have lived up to it spectacularly. CHOGMs are an occasion to take the pulse of the Commonwealth, to check that we continue in good health, to review how far we have come in the last 2 years, and to set signposts for the future.
Punctuated by another installment of fantastic song and dance, sending the packed River Theatre Auditorium into absolute awe and reflection, creating the ideal tone to welcome the history-making outgoing Commonwealth Chairperson, Trinidad and Tobago's Prime Minister Kamla Persad-Bissessar, who, by taking the podium, handed over the baton to her Australian counterpart, relinquishing the chair on a philosophical note.
It is clear that in order to build resilience on both the national and global levels, we must look to each other for support, for guidance, for examples, and for assistance. We must seek counsel from the wise and listen to the plight of the innocent.
And as if to seek direction from the clever, Commonwealth leaders and their guests then welcomed Her Royal Highness Queen Elizabeth II, who reflected on the past and cautioned the present into productive deliberations based on the shared values of the modern Commonwealth.
The results of this meeting may be global in impact, or simply touch a single individual, even imperceptibly. But in every respect, I trust that the results will be positive and enduring.
Well, the leaders have gone into retreat and will, over the next few days, have an opportunity to take a closer look at some of the recommendations that have been brought forward from meetings that were taking place here over the past few days. They will arrive, hopefully, at decisions that will impact positively the lives of 2.1 billion people across 54 nations of the Commonwealth. From Perth, Western Australia, this is Gideon Hanoomansingh reporting.